Hola guys, welcome to Cooking with Epic Empire. So today I'm gonna be making the Epic Empire sweet and sour sauce. So first I'm going to be using, well, I have my ingredients here. Y'all can't see.
We have a clip.
Oh, okay.
Hey guys, I'm over here, but.
Yes, yeah. She is here.
I'm frying ribs right now.
So we're gonna have a clip of all the ingredients we're gonna use for the Epic Empire sauce. So I'm gonna show you as I assemble it. Yeah, be right back. Okay guys, so first I'm gonna start off with 1 tablespoon of cornstarch. So, it's a big old spoon. Okay, so we're in a hotel, so we're gonna use this. Let me use this right here. We're gonna use this spoon for our tablespoon. Looks good to me. So next I'm gonna be adding 1 tablespoon of water. We'll just use the big spoon for this. Two-thirds of a cup of pineapple juice. Now y'all know I don't be measuring, right? So this is to taste anyway. It's a sauce. Mm-hmm. So 2/3 of a cup. We're gonna eyeball it.
Probably gonna be the whole can. Yeah.
Yeah.
Because the pineapple's in there.
That's about 2/3 of a cup.
Yeah, so we're making a lot of sauce, y'all. So this is for how many servings? I don't know, but we're making enough.
Yo, it doesn't, we don't know the serving size, but it's gonna be enough. Mm-hmm. And again, it's your own personal sauce, so you can adjust mm-hmm. it how you want to. So next I'm gonna be adding some rice vinegar. So I'm using the one by Kikkoman here. You can use whichever one is your favorite. So we're gonna do 2/3, I'm sorry, we're gonna do 1/3 of a cup of that.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Okay. So next we're gonna use about 1/3 of a cup of brown sugar. So your brown sugar of your choice, whatever you use. So again, eyeballing. That looks about like 1/3 of a cup. If you like your sweet and sour more sweet, just add more sugar.
And we probably will add more as we taste it.
Correct. We're gonna add more to our liking. So next is gonna be 3 tablespoons of ketchup. So Heinz, Hunt, whatever brand you like, Publix brand, dollar store, don't matter. It's 3 tablespoons of it. If you're a ketchup fanatic, you can do more. So next is 1 tablespoon of soy sauce. Dang, I gotta get them open. There we go.
What brand is that one?
This one is from the Asian market. Oh. I love this. Well, I like the one with the skinny man on it, but this one was okay.
I saw that one.
Yes. It's good.
And guys, so, the cornstarch is made to help thicken the sauce a little bit.
Yes.
That's why that's in.
So this is a 3, this is a teaspoon. So 3 teaspoons equal 1 tablespoon. That's why I put 3 of these in there. So, and you just mix it together. And we're gonna cook this, y'all. Yes. You probably wanna use a fork. Cause it's, you know, it acts as like a little whisk. Thank you. Mm-hmm. And just get all the lumps out. If you want to, guys, you can take the cornstarch and add a little bit of water and whisk it before then pour the sauce.
Yeah, so
we're gonna also put this on the stove. How long are we gonna let this cook? So it gets to the consistency, the desired consistency that we like. Okay, y'all, so of course this is your own sauce, so we're making our own. Garlic powder, I added more ketchup. A little bit more brown sugar, and I'm gonna add a little bit of hot sauce. We got a lot of ribs to coat, so. Now you add just the taste. Depending on how spicy you like your food. We don't mind a little heat over here. And then,
we'll be the epic empire ladies without some lemon. Lemon.
So we're gonna squeeze some lemon over top. And again, this is gonna cook on the stove, so it's gonna develop the flavors even more.
That lemon smells so good.
It does. Ooh, it smells so fresh.
Hey, hey. Oh yeah.
All right, y'all. So now to the soap.